make sure you're holding your hand. Glory to God. And all I'm simply asking you to do in 30 seconds is pray a prayer of blessing upon your neighbor. So often we take for granted that everybody is feeling the way they look. Everybody looks beautiful. But somebody had to fight to get here tonight. Somebody had a horrible 2019. And is still praying, God, please don't let me go through it again in 2020. Can we be unselfish for 30 seconds and just pray a prayer of blessing over our neighbor even right now? Come on, pray for your neighbor right now, right now, right now. You don't have to know their name. Just pray as the Spirit of God gave utterance. God, bless you. Come on, open your mouth up and pray. Open your mouth up and pray. Hallelujah, glory to God. We ask you now to heal. We ask you to heal and deliver our neighbor. We ask you to strengthen them. We ask you, oh God, where their mind balance, God, that you give freedom. You said in your word that with the Spirit of God is there's liberty, there's deliverance, there's healing, there's joy. So God, I ask you to bless my neighbor from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet, from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet. I ask you, God, to give peace. Hallelujah, where there's disturbance. I ask you to visit their home and draw the bloodline even right now. We pray, oh God, for that one that had a struggle to get here tonight. God, that you are working on that problem. Even as they're praising you, even as you're giving them glory, you're setting liberty in their house, liberty in their home, liberty in their marriage. Deliverance, God. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you even now that in your presence there's fullness of joy. So God, let joy reign in this place. Let liberty reign in this place. Let peace reign in this place. God, and we give you the glory even in advance. We give you the glory even in advance. We give you the glory even in advance. In Jesus' name. Now lose those hands and clap your hands and give God praise one more time. Sooner or later, it's going to turn in your favor. Glory to God. Why is somebody giving the praise in advance? Because if you believe even now that God's turning some things around in your favor. I said in your favor. He's turning some things around in your favor. Glory. I just learned that on the Hebrew calendar, that this is the year, I think it's 5780 in the Hebrew calendar. This is the year of the mouth. I'm saying it again, this is the year of the mouth. I preach it all Sunday. Be careful what you speak. Because I believe this is the season that you're going to see quick manifestation. I didn't say don't speak, I said be careful what you speak. So if you desire to see blessings, you desire to see healing, you need to open up your mouth and say something. Look at your neighbor and say something. Verse 1, Sister Tanishka Ferguson, Sister New Director, she's coming to read the Word of God to us. Let's put our hands together. Thank you, Lord. Thank you,
scripture is taken from Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1 to 3. Therefore, since these great promises are ours, beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from everything that contaminates and defiles body and spirit, and bring our consecration to completeness in the reverential fear of God. Do open your hearts to us again. Enlarge them. Take us in. We have wronged no one. We have betrayed or corrupted no one. We have cheated or taken advantage of no one. I do not say these to, I do not say this to reproach or condemn you. For I have said before that you are nested in our hearts, and you will remain there whether we die or live, it will be together. Here ends the scripture reading.
Let's receive Bishop Alfred Burris to come to lead us in a prayer for the chapter at this time. Can you stand? This night, a fresh anointing. Now listen, and I want you to listen really carefully. When I went to Government House, and they said at the time, is this killing Mr. Governor General? The Governor General is coming in. Nobody move. Nobody get up and go. I take worship very seriously. Because if I'm in the presence of the King, what I feel like doing. If I'm in the presence of the King, I can't even pay notice to who's on the left and who's on the right. My total focus is on the King. Worship is serious. Worship isn't just singing. Worship is acknowledgement of the one I'm worshiping. And as kingdom citizens, we got to realize when we are in the presence of the King. If you want to use the bathroom to pee, you got to hold it. Why? Because I'm in the presence of the King, and he is sitting high and he's lifted up. God wants to take you to another level or dimension in your worship to him. God wants you now, when you open your mouth, the year of the mouth, will be speaking with the Holy Spirit, or singing with the Holy Spirit, is functionalizing you to sing and not what you feel like. That means everybody here must have an ear to hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. You need to be filled with the power and the anointing of the Holy Ghost. God can make up a talent. He's looking for anointed worshipers from the heart. I want you to lift your hands to heaven. Oh, Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. upon them now. Sweet Holy Spirit, anoint them for the glory of God our Father. Father, be glorified. Be magnified. Be magnified. Be magnified. Breathe on them now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, oh, the glory.
Of Judah, behold your God. Behold, the Lord God will come with a strong hand, and his arm shall rule for him. Behold, his reward is with him, and his work before him. He shall feed his flock like a sheep herd. He shall gather the lambs with his arm, and carry them into his bosom, and shall gently lead those that are with young. The word of the Lord. That's already been
blessed. Amen. Come on, let's clap our hands and give God praise one more time. This is the consecration service, and so our mindset is really heavily on the presence of God, hearing from Him, receiving from Him. And so I beg you to stay in a mindset of worship. At this time, we're gonna have a special selection coming from the GMWA local chapter choir. Let's put our hands together for them as they come to minister one song. Dr. Miles, one of you used to say, clap it, it's good for the kitchen. Let's clap again, come on. Thank you. clap for them again.
He has brought us a mighty, mighty, mighty long way. Glory to God. I missed that song.
Yes.
Come on, let's give God praise again for the chapter of choir. You know, get your record. They sound like 100 just now. We have come to that part of this consecration service where we want to hear from God in terms of His Word. Worship is very, very important. The Word is very, very, very important. One of the things of the modern church today, I want you to listen to me very carefully, is that we have a lot of worship experience and we tear the roof off the church. And then we walk outside the doors and can't stand. Look at your neighbor and say, that's a problem. That's a huge problem. And what's happening is, what gives you standing ability is an understanding of the Word of God. John 15, verse 7. Says, if you abide in me, bless this, and my word abide in you, then you shall ask what you desire, and it shall be done. And many people are shouting with no word. So now I pray that your spirit comes ready to hear and to also receive what God has to say. And I have heard this young, he said he must put young there. Jennifer preached when I was a child, and always loved when it was his time up to preach, because I knew that not only would it be exciting, but it would be substantive, something to hold on to. So I pray even now, as Bishop Linda Wallace, who is the senior pastor here at the Grove Temple Church, comes to share the Word of God, that there will be illumination, that there will be power, and that you have something to help you to stand as you go forth. I come into agreement with what Bishop Barber says, that a shift comes upon you so that as the ministry goes forward, you will see the fruit, not only of other people's lives being transformed, but even your life going to another level. Amen? Let's put our hands together. Give God praise for the student who's coming. But just before he comes, Reverend Verona Seymour, Ronnie, as I know her, is coming to minister in song. When she's down, I would ask that you stand to receive Bishop Linda Wallace. Amen. All right, let's go first. She comes.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Come on, you could do better than that.
Yeah.
praise him. Tonight that we serve a God that we can feel him. We don't normally see him. You know, sometimes, but he's in the room. God bless you tonight. So grateful for this privilege to have been asked to encourage your hearts tonight, and I give due respect to the presence of God and to our presiding ambassador, my good friend Bishop Boris, distinguished leadership of this chapter of the American Gospel Workshop, our musicians, and indeed the Sister Seymour, who sang for us a while ago, and that choir that sang. I used to be like that one time, you know. I don't get there. Because based on what I heard tonight, it encourages my heart. So I'm going to get there one of these days, once again. Reverend Wayne, the Lord bless you. Thank you so much for having me to share tonight. And you see Pastor McDonald, we have here, and others that are here with us tonight. All of you, tonight, I want to thank God for you. Well, I have 3 hours to speak to you, and but I will. That's why I like you, because when I speak, you agree with me, you that smile, and that. You know, that really tells me that you're with me.
Amen.
Amen. But tonight, I'm privileged to be with you tonight, and I want to just share a word of encouragement to you as you embark on this new year. The thought that I got to look at was that you have come this far by faith. And this is my good friend sitting in front, you know, the Lord bless you. Boy, what a time to preach.
Come on, brother.
You know, it is so amazing when you never know who is who. Now, if I get here now and see the folks, then you start to, you know, amen, thank the Lord, you know, and call the devil all kind of liar. But the thing is that you see somebody that you can't look in the face. And God is good.
Yes, sir.
I'm telling you. Amen. And so tonight I want to just encourage your hearts. But I'll give you a brief historical setting in about 2 minutes as to why we can appreciate where you are tonight. It is always good to know where you came from or where you come from. Then you could appreciate where you are, and of course, where you're going. Too many times we take things for granted, and sometimes we believe that things has happened, but somebody paved the way and somebody had paid the price. That's what Jesus did for us, you know, so we can rejoice tonight. We come this far by faith. During the mid-70s, God saw the need of a chapter connecting the Bahamas to the family of the Americas. in promoting the gospel through music. Representatives were, in the beginning, Reverend Alfred Josey, Reverend Patrick Smith, the late Arthur Preacher Roll, among many others. Promoting, and these were the pioneers of bringing what we are celebrating tonight, giving God glory for bringing us this far. With confidence, He did not bring us this far to leave us. We have an awesome an assurance in the words of Holy Scripture. My grace is sufficient, and my strength is made perfect in your weakness. The latter part of that verse simply means when you would have been at your weakest point, that's when God wants to establish Himself. So therefore you can stand with boldness, confidence, knowing that you have a God who promises and will keep His promise, never fails, never runs short. But I like something that Ambassador mentioned, that we need more than just singing, excitement. And one of my philosophy is that we should not allow excitement to override reality. But we have seen so much of that in the 21st century church, where there's a lot of excitement. Big blaze and no heat.
Go away now. Go away now.
Big blaze.
Go away now.
No heat. There are four ingredients, distinctive essentials, that is important in what you do as a group. Willingness, obedience, Jesus. Loyalty, and faithfulness. I taught, and I always talk about here at church and at school, as something that is called balance. And we should not be so earthly, that so heavenly, that we know earthly good. In other words, we need to create a balance. Some years ago, all of us only have Sesame Street to watch. So everybody run home to get Sesame Street at 5 o'clock. That's not true, that's only for us. But there was an evening when they were on the boat, Big Bird and Gopher, and all of them was riding on the boat across the lake. And so the little boat began to sink because all of them were on one side of the boat. And so what they did, they discovered that this was going the wrong direction. So what they did, all of them went to the other side. So it was from one extreme to the next extreme. What was key was that they should have little and balance the boat. What I'm saying to us tonight, beloved, is that with all we do, we are to ensure that there is a balance. When you would have left here this evening, all this beautiful singing, it's fine. But when you reach back to your office and tomorrow, you can't sing like you do here. So you need something inside of you to keep. So when your next neighbor get on your last nerve, Lord help us. Instead of telling them a piece of your mind, you begin to give them the word of God. Hallelujah. Because there is that battle. That's why the scripture says we should let our conversation be seasoned with grace, that we may know how to answer every man at the time of need. Listen to this, the man dresser goes down. In the military, there is, all are trained in the academy for police work. Same trainers, same everything, so on and so forth. But when it's all finished, there are some special operations that not all those who pass through the academy is able to take part in. So there's a selected few from the squad, so to speak, to perform certain operandus or operations. One of the things was they must be physically, mentally fit. High level of confidentiality, loyalty, which is an ingredient in the church today that is seemingly disappearing.
So true, so true.
Loyalty.
So true.
Yes.
Listen, beloved. In what you're doing, it might not so much be as the physical strength where you fight and carry on or what have you. But you must be sound in faith.
Yes, yes, yes.
Sound in the word of God. Be able to stand flat-footed when it comes to defending the truth of God's word. Because listen to what Paul said to Timothy. That the time will come when men will not endure sound doctrine.
I know you're right.
Giving ears to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils and all the other things that goes around. And today we find in our churches, in our community in which you serve, that there are any number of physicians, but the patients are dying right, left, and center. There are any number of prophecies and prophetic words and all like that. But the thing about it is the manifestation is not being seen according to the prophetic word. Because Jeremiah said many are sent, are went, but God didn't send them. And there is a word in the Gospel of Luke that Jesus promised you and said, I am going to leave you. But don't leave Jerusalem until you be, my term, in season, be endued with power, that you are able to carry on the work. Then there's another thing, commitment. There are a lot of beginners and starters, but there's no commitment. You know, the thing about it, in my term, we have a lot of what you call fear weather sailors. They can sail when the weather is good. It's fine. But when there's a little turbulence, they can't stand. So they, John called them, according to it, hirelings. They're 9-to-5 workers. Only from 9-to-5, when they finish, they knock off and they go. And so Jesus called them in the Gospel of John, the hirelings. Yes, but we're talking about one that is committed, yes, that it will cost your life.
Yes.
It says the good shepherd, Jesus said, gave his life, yes, for the sheep. Yes. So you're committed to the task. Yes. Whether life or death, and that's where Revelation said, be faithful unto death.
Amen.
Not until death, but unto death, that even if death is facing you, you're going to stand up. My God forever.
Jesus.
I think I'm just about done.
Lord.
The assignment that you're undertaking, beloved, is always dangerous. Hidden minds, snipers of all kind, backbiters, hazers, malicious folks, and Jesus said they would even kill you and think that it's who God serves. You know, you sing well, and who do you think he is? But God give every man according as his several ability. And that's one of the problems we have in ministry today. You know, I could sing, but you know, I think I like how he prayed. So I want to do that. But it doesn't work like that. This mission that you have, beloved, Jesus said it's a dangerous assignment, but the pay is good. And if you notice, even I give you an instant in electricity, especially those people with the high tension wiring stuff, their pay is excellent, but the risk is high. In what you're doing, the risk is high, because you have a standard to maintain. You have a God to uphold. You have some principles to maintain. You know why? Because there are some folks that are watching you.
Yeah.
And the thing about it all, the thing about this, beloved, is that you don't know all who is watching you. When I came here at this local assembly a couple of years ago, I was dealing with a fellow some 20, 25 years, maybe more. And he knew me, I didn't know him. And he happened to become a member of this local assembly. And when he came in, he said, I was watching you for over 25 years.
Wow.
Never know him, but he knew me.
Yes,
when he came and saw me, he said, I was watching you for over 25 years. Yes. Point I'm making, beloved, is this. Once you would have sang on this choir,
yes,
you're no longer on audio, but you become on stream.
Yes,
so folks are going to see you.
Yes.
See, and it's a difference. They can hear you fine. Anybody can discard the voice. But when they see you, oh, that's the man there, that's the woman there. Listen to this. Beloved, I want to encourage you tonight to ensure continuity in the gospel message that you're doing. Paul said, the things that you would have done, commit to faithful men that they may teach others. It would be vain if you leave your scene and there's nobody to fill when you leave off. This is one of the biggest problems we have today in ministry, in where you are and where we are, is that folks would have served for 20 years and when you would have left, there's nobody to fill your shoes. That's not good. I have known where folks have served for 50 years. And I was told in Guyana, there's a gentleman who served for 45, almost 50 years. And when it was time for him to die, he cried. And he said, you know why I'm crying? There is nobody. In other words, he did not pass on nothing to anybody. And so it bothers his mind to know that he's leaving the scene and there's nobody to carry on. Beloved, listen, I call you tonight to ensure that what you have, pass it on to someone else.
Amen.
See, there is what you have, the talents you have, and the giftings you have, it's no use to you.
Amen.
Listen to what Ephesians 4 says. He gave some pastors, he gave some teachers, he gave some singing, some to pray, I didn't know in. For the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, till we all come in the unity of the faith. What it would be if Wendy would have finished, because don't tell them what they tell us is a secret. All of us are getting older, you know. Yes. What you could have done, mind I told you, if I hear second noise, you talk. But give and take, in another figure of speech, couple of days, you're not going to behold that tenor like you do tonight. But if you have, Lord help us, if you have somebody that can sing like me, then you're good. And if I could help somebody as I pass along, then my living will not be in vain. Beloved, one or two things and I'm done. There are some criteria that must be maintained as you serve. One of those things, before I get to that, one of those things you need to pay attention to is that in this thing, this ministry that you serve in, there are no CEOs. Let me repeat that. In this ministry that you serve in, there are no CEOs. We are all servants. Jesus says, I come not to be served, but I come to serve. And that's what you're called to do, to serve. That's why God handpicked you. You didn't see that one coming. That's why God handpicked you. Because you would have met the qualification. You fit, confidential, strong, you sound, you balance. Because the enemy has never taken a break.
Never does.
And all he waits for is to get you off balance. And he will do you like the story of the frog. Put the frog in some hot water and he'll jump up. Put him in some cold water. Gradually turn the heat up, and he stay right there, gets comfortable. And before long, you have frog soup. That's not for free. The enemy, if he gets you off balance, he will get you at a point where you are comfortable. And before you know it, you're heading the wrong direction. And when you catch yourself, it's too late because you cannot regain yourself. There are any number of persons that was watching you to make a change. And when you would have become frog soup, they said, my goodness, I just was waiting. Man, she disappointed me. I just was waiting to join that choir. Boy, I don't know who to trust.
My Lord. Amen. My Lord.
So, submit yourselves to the Lord. Trust also in Him. The wise man Proverbs said, lean not to your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge God, and He will direct your pathway. Be obedient towards the things of God, and in obedience to God's word. Listen to what John said chapter 15. For without me, you can do nothing. In that same prayer, in the prayer of chapter 17 that Jesus prayed, you have an assurance that God is going to be with you. He said, sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth. And then he went further than that. He said, I pray not that you take them out of the world, but that you keep them from the evil of the world. That means you have the assurance of Jesus Christ to be with you every step of the way. Amen. So there's no reason for you to feel discouraged or out of place, because David said in the Psalms, he has a mighty strong arm and high is his right hand. I encourage you tonight, beloved, your assignment may be dangerous, but Jesus Christ, the captain of the host, he never fails.
Amen.
Cast your care upon him, for he cares for you. He assures you that he will never leave you, neither will he forsake you. I close with this. There is a Samaria that you may have to go, where there's some might never heard about what you're sharing. Like the deacon Philip, but he went and he preached Christ. In your singing, let Jesus be uppermost.
Amen.
True worship, worship is given, but there's a lack of true worship today. And that's what you are called to do, to preserve true worship. Yeah. It's clear in chapter 4 of the Gospel of John, where the ladies spoke to the lady and she said, we worship in this mountain. But Jesus said, the hour has come when the true worshiper must worship the Father in spirit and in truth. You are called tonight, beloved, to establish that truth wherever you go. Yes, the worshiping. But you need true worship, for the Father seeks such to worship him.
Amen.
God has promised you an assurance that he will never leave you. That's why God chose you, like the shepherd, willing to put your life on the line so that others might live. With confidence, speak with authority as an ambassador for Christ. Hear what Jesus says. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to sing the gospel of Christ, to establish true worship, to conduct myself in a manner that if Jesus walking on my conversation, if he comes in when I'm singing, hallelujah to God. And listen to this. Don't be afraid. Divine protection is guaranteed. I will never leave you. I will be with you. When your rivers come down, he will be a bridge over troubled water. When the heat get hot, he will be a cooling system. Hallelujah. There is a fourth man in the building.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Down the side three. And listen to this secret. They didn't tell you this one. Meaning, beloved, when the king said, we throw three, and we saw four, and the fourth man looked like the Son of God. Well, here is the secret. Even when they took out those three, the fourth man still was in the fire. Hallelujah to God. So what I'm saying to you tonight, in your time, Jesus Christ is still in the fire. So let them throw you in, because the fourth man.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let them try you in the fire.
tonight was going through a fire.
Oh, Jesus.
And thought they were in there alone. Bishop just brought a revelation today. The fourth man never left the fire. Look at somebody to the right and left and say to them, you got company in there with you. Somebody left somebody who was crazy. They need Jesus to be in their fire. Look at your neighbor and say to them one more time. Someone's in that fire with you. Heard a song, but I said, Holy Ghost, that's not the song that's on this paper. I ain't heard this song in a long time. Now I see what the Holy Ghost is saying this song. Y'all didn't have to know the words, but I know it ties in with what he just finished off just now. No, never alone. To leave me. Real quickly, a charge of consecration. Pastor Marima Gon is coming with that charge at this time. And we're just about done with this part of the service, and then we're gonna sing ourselves some more happy. Let's bless God before she comes.
Where it is the skill of dentistry, a cup of cold water, a friendly chat, or a warm smile that you share. We are sending you to do it in His name. Go with our blessing and His anointing, our prayers, and His enabling, our provisions, and His empowering. We commission you to go in Jesus' name. And all of God's people say,
amen.
You go forth. And as I've said, as much as possible, use words that you preach the gospel. Yes, God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. I'm going to pinch hit and pray for these officers. I'm going to ask everybody to please stand and stretch your hands towards them. As I pray, I want to read. I don't share this with a whole lot of people, but years ago when I started out in evangelism ministry, the Holy Ghost, I prayed and I asked, how do I present myself? I was going places and saying, minister this or pastor this. And then I started knocking on a few doors, and places I would knock on, when they heard I was a minister, they would slam the door. Because of so many scary stories. This happened to my child in church. This pastor did this to me. And I'm like, Lord, you didn't give me something. Under that inspiration, I heard ambassador. Now, I've been teasing and ridiculed using it. I've been in services and heard pastors talk, sitting 10 feet away from me, laughing at me. What is he doing with this nonsense? And they don't even know the scripture. 2 Corinthians 5:20. I didn't say it to be a big time at all. I said it to stay assignment focused.
Yeah.
That when I go, I am a representative of the kingdom of heaven, not on my own assignment. And instead of people slamming doors, he started saying, what does that mean? I said, I'm glad you asked. 2 Corinthians 5, I'm reading it to you before I pray. Verse 18, you may start using it after today. And all things are of God who hath reconciled us, this is verse 18, reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ and hath given to us the ministry of reconciliation. To know that God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their trespass unto them, and hath committed unto us the word of reconciliation. Listen carefully, verse 20. Now then we are ambassadors for Christ. As though God did beseech you by us, we pray you in Christ's stead, be ye reconciled to God. You call this as ministers of reconciliation. Let's keep that in the forefront of our mind as you lead, that you be the examples for others to follow. Amen. Stretch your hands towards the Father in the name of Jesus, God. We thank you for these persons who have stepped forward. Leadership, God, it is a privilege, but it's also a calling out to be picked on. Father, I thank you for your word. In Psalms 34:19, you said many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord shall deliver him out of them all. I pray, God, that you bless them now from the crown of their heads to the soles of their feet. Some of them are standing now, God, and they have challenges that they have to face. I pray, God, that you lift every burden, that you destroy every yoke. I pray peace of mind. I also pray peace in their homes and also in their relationships. Destroy the plan of the enemy concerning their lives. I speak confusion to the plan of the enemy even now. And I pray, God, you lift them up, that you will strengthen them, that you will unify them, hallelujah, God, and that they be carriers of the gospel. And even, God, as they minister to your people, I pray, God, that the spirit of empathy be upon them, that they be sensitive, that they be concerned, God, that they be empowered, God, to help those who they lead. Father God, for their assignment is great, to set an atmosphere for the Holy Ghost to inhabit. God, we need your presence.
Thank you, Jesus.
Use them mightily. Provide for them. Strengthen them. You come against confusion. And God, even as you send them out as ambassadors of the kingdom and ambassadors of this country when they move, cause them, God, to be difference makers. Cause them, God, to shift atmospheres. Minister deliverance and healing and salvation. And we ask this in no other name but the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody come on, put your hands together in the name of God. thank you so much. It's been a powerful service thus far. I don't know what I'm supposed to continue with somebody else takes over the afternoon. Well, bless be the name of the Lord. This is continue. All right. Well, I don't know how many of you here have been to GMWA overseas before, the national event. Oh, not many people. Okay. Well, I went a long time ago, and I passed through if I was in the city at the time. And this kind of time here now is early in GMWA time.
Yes.
People still walking around eating. 9 o'clock. They do an event that goes till about 11 o'clock, and then they let you know where they're gonna be at midnight. And that's usually when the conversation happens. I met some great people during that session. Well, this is our abbreviated version. This is the Afterglow concert. And we are so honored, I believe this is who their name is. We are so honored to have new voices in the house. Come on, GMWA, that's not your true respect. Yes. We're so glad to have new voices.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. And he is worthy to be praised. Come on, let's put our hands together for the Lord. And come on, let's put our hands together for the service tonight. God is indeed good. And the man of God said tonight that we've all come from a mighty long way. We've come from some place. And we know pain. All of us in here know some tears. All of us in here know some downfalls. All of us in here know some trouble. But God was faithful. He was so faithful to bring us through.
It was
Thank you.
Consecration Combined Choirs, Voice of Seed, say it again, and Redemption Combined Choir.
Brief readings tonight from Seed of Rich Ministry under the leadership of Bishop Luther Thurston and Pastor Irina Thurston, who's sitting in the back. And Seed of Reach Ministry, a covering ministry for Redemption Gospel Ministry, where I am the pastor, and we like to join in with your celebration of consecration, of singing praises unto our God. And we just going to sing a few songs and praise in celebration the way that we serve one God. He's the same God yesterday.
Yes, he is.
He's the same God today. He's the same God forevermore. Bishop Wallace, and to all the fine hosts, we greet you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
all this?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. My hallelujah belongs to you. Sing it, my hallelujah. My hallelujah belongs. No, play, seriously. To you. My hallelujah. My the best of me. Say it one more time. My hallelujah. My hallelujah belongs to you. I feel like somebody is shifting in this atmosphere. My hallelujah. My hallelujah. Hey, glory. Belongs to you. Sing you. Chapter choir closing us out. This has been a wonderful experience for me. I enjoyed it. Amen.
Amen.
To get Bishop Wallace preaching and this kind of worship, this is heaven on earth.
Amen.
Let's bless God for angelic angels as they dance before the Lord this time.
To me, Paul says, to me who am blessed and the least of all the saints, this grace was given that I should preach among the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Christ, and to make all see what is the fellowship of the mystery, which from the beginning of the ages has been hidden in God, who created all things through Jesus Christ. I love this verse though. To the intent that now the manifold wisdom of God might be made known by the church to the principalities and powers in the heavenly places. Never forget the assignment that is on the church. That is not just about, because we get so bogged down in the things that we go through. And we forget that we were made to declare things not just to people, but to spirits in the heavenly places. You were made to teach some demons some stuff about God. You were made to declare to every high place that it's coming down in Jesus' name, that God's people are victorious, that we are the kingdom, that we win every fight because the power of God is with us. I was listening to an old Fred Hammond record, and the woman was talking, I think her name was Kim, and she said, we have the most prestigious seat in the kingdom. We're seated with Christ in heavenly places. We give glory to the Lamb tonight. If you don't mind lifting your hands, you can clap, whatever you want to do to just honor the Lord. If you want to just shout, whatever you want to do, you can just do it right now. I'm not going to tell you what to do. But Lord, your kingdom blesses you tonight. It comes, God, your people declare some things tonight. That you are most worthy to receive glory and honor and power. And of his kingdom there shall be no end. Glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb.
This is why. For he is an
Omega.
Forever is he. Thank you. Forever.
Good evening. We just want to thank you just for the time. We're going to say the benediction, then we're going to go praising the Lord. Praise God. While you're praying tonight, keep my family in prayer. I'm traveling on Wednesday. My wife has a doctor's appointment for a procedure on Thursday in Miami, Florida. So keep us in your prayers. Amen?
Amen.
Most gracious and heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, and we glorify you, Lord Jesus. What has been said, Lord, what has been done, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for your presence, Lord. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for, Lord, restoring, Lord, soul. We thank you, Lord Jesus, Lord, for bringing people's minds back, Lord Jesus, Lord, to you, Lord. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for your anointing, Lord Jesus, afresh on each and every one that is here tonight. Lord, not for form or fashion, Lord, but Lord, we come, Lord, to your honor and your glory, Lord Jesus. Lord, as we depart from this place, Lord, go with us, Lord. Keep your anointing, Lord. Keep the fire burning, Lord Jesus. Anoint us, Lord, with fire, Lord Jesus. Lord, as we go, Lord, that we will be, Lord Jesus, doers of your word, Lord. That, Lord, people will see, Lord, you, Lord Jesus, in us, Lord. And they will say, I yield, and no more want to live in sin, Lord Jesus. We glorify you and we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.